So in this particular problem, what we have is laminar flow between parallel plates. And the velocity distribution is given by U over big U equals 1 minus 2y over h, that whole quantity squared. This big U, generally we use a big U when we're talking about a fixed plate and a moving plate, and that big U is the velocity of the moving plate. However, when you're talking about flow, laminar flow between parallel plates, generally what's causing the flow is not a moving plate, but it's pressure driven. So instead of saying big U, we actually say U max, which is the maximum velocity of the fluid, and that's going to be what we normalize our velocity distribution by. And so what we are asked to do here is consider water at 15 degrees C. U max equals 0.10 meters per second, and h, which is the distance separating the plate, is 0.25 millimeters. And we are going to set the origin midway between the plates. And the reason for that is if you actually drew the velocity distribution, it would look like this. And what you should hopefully be able to see from it is that it's symmetrical, with the max being at the origin right here. And what we're asked to find is the shear stress on the upper plate and its direction. So our governing equation is that the shear stress, or tau, equals mu, which is the viscosity, du dy. So where do we find the viscosity? Well, the reason that they tell us it's water at 15 degrees C is that we go to a table, look up the viscosity of water at 15 degrees C, and we find that it equals 1.14 times 10 to the minus 3 newton seconds per meter squared. The next thing we do is take the derivative of U with respect to y, and we have to rewrite it as u equals u max 1 minus 2y over h, the quantity squared. So when we take this derivative, it's again a relatively simple derivative. We find that du dy equals u max minus 4y over h times 2, or minus 8 u max y over h squared. Sorry, I forgot that h squared down there. So we're trying to find the shear stress on the upper plate. So if you recall, our origin is in the center, and our y in the plus direction is like that. So what we're really trying to find is du dy at y equals positive h over 2. And so when we put that in our equation, we find that our tau equals mu, then minus 8 u max over h squared times h over 2, which is minus 4 mu u max over h. And so when we put our numbers in, including what our h is and our viscosity that we looked up, we find that our tau is minus 1.83 newtons per meter squared. Notice that's a force divided by an area. Since our tau is a negative number, what direction does it act in? It has to act in the negative direction or against the flow. So what if we were asked to find it instead on the lower plate? Now, instead of having y be h over 2, y would be negative h over 2. And so what would the difference be? The difference would be that the magnitude would be the same. However, the sign would change. So you'd have the exact same magnitude, but in a different direction. And finally, let's check to make sure that max is actually at the center. And so how do we do that? Well, what we do is we find du dy. And again, that's negative 8 u max y over h squared. And how do we find what the maximum is? You take the derivative and set it equal to 0. So we set this equal to 0. And so the only way that could be is if y equaled 0, the way we set up our coordinate system. For fun, what you might want to do is change the coordinate system, put it on the very bottom, and see how that changes your answer.